Welcome to this clear fact. Today we have a very interesting question, a question that we have a lot of times. When your patients are in treatment, do you make them change the aligners every week, every 10 days, or every other week?
Now this is what we're gonna answer today in this clear fact.
My name is Stephane Reinhardt. I'm the director of the education program for the Clear Institute.
And my name is Michaela Sehnert. I'm a general dentist from Germany.
And we answer the question right after this. If you like these videos, don't forget to subscribe on the channel. If you're not subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? And give us the thumbs up.
And don't forget to click on the little bell that you're going to be notified every time we're going to upload a new
ding ding. Michaela!
Stephane!
I know this question comes often to you, to me, every time we lecture, lecture online or a live course. We started live courses again. We always have that question from dentists. Do you make your patient change aligners every week, every 10 days? Every other week? I had a dentist who was changing aligners every 3 weeks. So what's your protocol?
Our protocol is the patient changes every week. So let's say a patient comes to my office on a Monday, receives their aligners, they're always going to change on Monday. So I exactly know 10 aligners, going to be 10 weeks.
Did you always do it like that? When you started, did you change every other week, or and then you change, or from the start you already were at 1 week?
From the start I was at 1 week. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I go a little bit down, but that's really rare.
What do you mean?
With the wearing time.
What
like
do you
for
mean?
Teenagers, for example, when I see it's working really well.
Can you really treat teenagers with clear aligners?
Only in Germany.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, they're really good patients.
They are.
That's sometimes we think teenagers will not wear the aligners. That's not true. My experience is that they're as good. They are as good as adults.
Yes, that is true. And I mean, also the anatomy and, or the growth sometimes. For us, what we see, they're able to wear less time. That's what I experienced, to have exactly the same
when
outcome.
You say less time, what do you mean?
Each day they have to wear them, like we always say, wear them 24 hours, just to remove them, maybe during eating, but wear them for a week or to the other. But our teenagers, sometimes they're going to change after 5 days.
Okay.
We stick usually to the week to make it easier for the patient. You know, that we can calculate when we're going to see the patient again. But what is really nice, the patient has now that my Invisalign app.
Yeah.
You know, and
yeah.
So they can even put inside, what is your rhythm of changing?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you know exactly on the calendar when you have to see the dentist again, how many aligners, you know, maybe you have in total on your treatment. So this is pretty much
in
easier.
Fact, they receive a message telling them
Absolutely.
To change the aligner. So
Absolutely.
If it's every 5 days, they will receive a message reminding them to change the aligner.
So
how did you come up with this thing of changing every 5 days?
Because the teenagers were telling us, you know, after 4 or 5 days, I don't have no pressure anymore, nothing, you know. And what we could see when they were at our clinics, the movement was done,
mm-hmm.
you know. So in general, of course, they are always, you know, maybe a person or a patient where it doesn't work that well. But what we see mm-hmm. on our teenagers, mm-hmm. we can really easily say change every 5 days.
Now is the part where, you know, if you would be polite, you would ask, and you, Stephane, what is your story? You've been doing aligners for a long time now. What is your story? Do you change every week? Every 2 weeks?
I expected a little bit that you change weekly to make it really easy, you know?
But what's my story? I've been
Stephane,
using...
Stephane, you know what? What is your story?
That's it. I'm
behind...
I'm very happy you asked and you're interested in my story. I've been using clear aligners, Invisalign, since 2004.
everything was in black and white.
And when we started, it was the protocol was changing every other week. Of course, the aligners were not the same. I mean, the plastic was not the smart track. It was not the same plastic. It was more stiff, more, it looked and it felt more like a retainer. So we were changing every other week. And even at that time, patients were telling us that, you know, the second week, they didn't feel a thing. They had the impression that nothing was happening. And what happened with time is we started with some patient, with some treatment, to change the aligners every week instead of every other week. And we saw that it was working well, and if not better. The other thing, like you said, it's easier for the patients to remember. Now, what happened is Align, knowing this, because more and more and more providers were, you know, changing every week, they changed the plastic with the smart track, and they came up with that protocol of changing the aligners every week, every 7 days. But based on what? Now, this is the thing. You know, in your practice, do you base your treatment on your clinical experience or on scientific evidence? And I'm not saying one is better than the other. But
yeah. Well, when I started, of course, I was looking at what, what did the study say, or what did other, practitioners experience before. But with time, when I did more treatments, of course, I have my own experience. So this is why we came up with our protocol, what we have
exactly
nowadays.
What works for you, what works in your hand.
Absolutely.
The thing is, I always like to look at scientific evidence. Clinical experience, is good. And there's not only one good way to do things. Otherwise, we would all do the same thing. We would all use the same product. But still, if I can find some scientific literature to convince me that what I'm doing is right, I like it. And I found something. An article talking about this. I mean, how often should we change the aligners? And it's not an article from 2010, it's an article from 2021. And the article is the effect of clear aligner wear protocol on the efficacy of tooth movement. And it's a randomized clinical trial. And what they did, they compared the wear time at 7 days, 10 days, and 14 days. And you know what the conclusion is? For some difficult posterior movement, it's better to change every other week. But the difference is so small that finally it's better to change every week, because it's going to take you twice the time to do the movement. And even if it's not following as well after, you know, every week, you're going to do maybe some additional aligners, but you will gain some time anyway by doing it like that. So my protocol, what I do, is change every week also, like you're doing. I did not try the 5 days thing. Mm-hmm. And I'm confident that it would work a lot of times, probably with teenagers. The reason why I keep it like this is that I think it's easier for my patients. Mm-hmm. The other thing is that it's not more chair time for me.
Absolutely.
That's the other thing. It doesn't change anything clinically with that. You know, it's always a balance between, you know, financial and clinical. You know, you need financial success and clinical success. So if you would see your patient every aligner, like I heard once, don't do that. But that would not be profitable. I mean, at one point, you have to be profitable.
That's true. But, you know, another point, what is maybe a small point for us, but what I think is also really important for the patient, the hygiene. If you have an aligner for only a week, I mean, it feels much more, nice and clean. Mm-hmm. So this is why we stick minimum, we say, okay, sometimes 5 days, but maximum 7 days, you're going to change. And if there would be a movement, like you said, a tooth that is not on track, at good, we're going to go with additional aligners and focus on that tooth.
That's
still
it.
With 1 week changing time.
Exactly. So. Well, what I do, what I prefer to do, instead of telling the patient to change every other week, if I see there are some more difficult movement or teeth that are not following as well, I will reduce the velocity of movement and still change the aligners every week.
Yeah.
Good idea.
Very good. We.
Are you happy now that you know my story?
I'm so happy. Mm-hmm. I'm so glad I asked.
I'm so glad that it came naturally.
This is how I am.
Oh, very good. If you want to know more about clear aligners and protocols and all these things related to clear aligners and Invisalign, don't hesitate to go on the Clear Institute learning platform. All the information are in the comments below. You will find courses, live courses, online courses, learning programs, everything you need to master clear aligners and make it a success in your practice.
And if you have a crazy protocol on wearing aligners, we would really like to see them in the comments below.
Share it with us, please. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, I mean, if you're still there, it's because you like this video, right? So give us the thumbs up, subscribe to the channel.
And don't forget to click on the little bell. You're gonna be notified every time we upload a new video.
Ding, ding. I'm Stephane Reinhardt, Director of Education Program for the Clear Institute.
And my name is Michaela Sehnert. I'm a general dentist from Germany.
And we will see you in the next video. Have fun making.